right. Good evening. Thank you for being here. Please follow my example. Take your phone out. Put it on silent. This habit will suit you well even leaving the concert. All right. My name is James Wilder, Dr. James Wilder. I am helping Dr. Madriguera's students. You'll see I'm in a sweater vest today in honor of our dear departed Dr. Madriguera, who knew how to properly wear a sweater vest. I apologize. So we will start with our Guitar 1. You can follow along in the program. We have Guitar 1 students. We have Guitar 2 class and Guitar Ensemble. I will play with the Guitar Ensemble, Dr. Madriguera's ensemble. These are his selections, and I'm happy to help the students get to the end of this spring semester. We're excited for you to hear it. I do want to start with an introduction from our Dean, Dr. Niels Romer, Dean of the Bass School of Arts, Humanities, and Technology, also holds a distinguished chair in Arts, Humanities, and Technology, has the unique, of all my colleagues, has the unique, has seen me hold an electric guitar at one time many, many years ago, playing cover music on the streets of DFW. I don't think any other of my colleagues have known that, so... we will not hear from Mr. Russell Cleveland, who is the chair, head of our Guitar Advisory Council. I'm sure he'll watch this. Hello, Russell. We miss you. I'm sure he'll enjoy this. Yes, thank you, Russell. Mr. Russell Cleveland is a guitar collector, is a donor for the program, along with many of our other fine donors, many of whom are here tonight. Some of the instruments you'll hear tonight are specifically from donations from our very generous council, and of course the funds that help things as the competition that I'm sure you just enjoyed this early in March. So, without further ado, I'd like to welcome Dr. Niels Romer, our Dean of Arts, Humanities, and Technology.
Thank you. Good evening for everyone being here. I think the very fact that we're here with so many guitars already says a great deal about who we want to remember tonight as well, Enric. His own past or his history with the university stretches back actually by quite a few years. Just to kind of give you a little bit of a history of him. Born in 1950, the year 1969, he decided to move to Spain to further his education. 69 was a good year. Others traveled to the moon. He kind of pursued his dream in Spain. But then he returned and got his MA in 84 at the University of Texas in Dallas in the Arts and Humanities School, and then his PhD in 93. He altogether has served 45 consecutive years here at the university, starting in 1979. So I know we're all in the arts and humanities, but if you just kind of indulge me for a moment and play the math a little bit through how many of these events he would have organized, how many guitar players are out there today who would have benefited from his education, thinking about that legacy, just in terms of what he's created in classrooms, this is an endless guitars if you just think about 45 years of consecutive teaching here. Which also means he's seen a lot of changes. 45 years ago, this was a slightly different place. I don't even know where those classes would have taken place 45 years ago. Well, that was just built barely, probably not quite yet looking like it is today. For me, aside from him and his many accomplishments in guitar and teaching, we had that other kind of unique thing going that because of his wife, he knew some German. And the words that he used on me always made me particularly happy. Jawohl was one of them, which most of my other faculty barely ever says. And so I appreciated that always, that he was always ready for whatever. But most importantly, even down to the very last days, he was always full of more energies and full of new ideas and plans. Just a couple of days before he died, he came and visited me and had these incredibly excited eyes on. He had a new guitar. And so he was about as proud as one could be, showing it off and, you know, thinking about all the great things that he was going to do. But I have a couple of other things here that I want to share with you just to kind of remind everyone about what he's accomplished over the years. Also really being excited about us being able to record his performances in a professional manner. His office is really an archive of love and tender and affection that he has bestowed upon his guitars and upon his students. You would have to see the office and really to appreciate how much love and affection there is in that room in terms of endless amounts of recordings and notes and scribbles and things that he had done. Exceptionally passionate professor, but I have a few things here that I just want to highlight as well. In October 2009, Dr. Madriguera became the first holder of the Russell Cleveland Professorship in Guitar Studies, a big marking stone for the build-up of our guitar program, of which you are now part, but also really a recognition of his great many accomplishments. Being a holder of a chair and being invested with that is about as good as it gets in an academic career. If you've ever seen him on official, you know, functions, graduations being one of them, he wore one of those big medallions, we call them bling, and he was always particularly proud of that one and felt really, really excited about bringing it out. He was also the co-founder of our traditional Texas guitar competition and festival that has just taken place this year, the 22nd time. See, I'm making sure that I'm a historian, I shouldn't get my numbers mixed, so I'm just making sure that I don't. But the thing that really struck with me, and this was just passed on to me, annually we go through annual reviews, and so I meet all my faculty kind of to see what they've respectively have done in the last year. And so he had apparently prepared himself, and one of the things that, you know, was in there was, my goal is to establish an essential center for the study, performance, and research of classical guitar culture. That was his stated goal, and I think so it should remain. Thank you all for being here and participating and continuing that mission. Thank you.
All set. All right. Thank you, Dr. Romer. I would like to begin. Dr. Madriguera was always fantastic about grouping selections into categories and genres. In this Guitar One class, we will begin with music that is English folk music, in most cases all instrumental music. So they have pre-programmed dances and steps and the like, of which I will not attempt for you today. These are three pieces, All in a Garden Green, The South Wind, and Keppel's Delight. I hope you enjoy. One thing I wanted to mention before we get started, all the Guitar One classes have done fantastic this semester. Every single class, in most cases, has no music reading ability to start, doesn't know how to hold and pluck the guitar. Believe me, it is a difficult instrument just to get a sound out of it. And hasn't started with any skill in playing music with other people. So I applaud all the Guitar One students and Guitar Two and Guitar Ensemble. You've done fantastic work in 15, 16 short weeks. Okay. Thank you very much. Here are three English folk songs. Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Professor Hodan, and I have two classes tonight that are going to play. This is 001 class, and in a moment we'll have the 501 class. And I've been friends with Rick for many, many years. The first concert that he played in Dallas was at a Brook Mays at Valley View Center. And I attended that concert. I still have the program, as a matter of fact. And I was a young student at SMU at the time. And I welcomed him to Dallas. And I said, if there's anything I can do to help you, I would be honored. And little did I know that that would be 40 years in the making. And anyway, he was a great professor here at UTD, but also a great friend of mine. Anyway, it was a very sad occasion, unexpected, as you all know. And anyway, we dedicate these pieces to him. This first class is going to play four pieces. And one of the unique things about my class this semester is I included a lot of pieces that had a lot of chromatics in the pieces. And that's a little bit more advanced for the beginning classes. And they learned the pieces, and I hope they'll play them wonderfully tonight for you. I'm looking forward to that. We're going to take just a minute and tune up briefly, and then we'll get to the music in just a moment. Thank you. This is my 501 class, and we're going to do a different set of pieces. You have those in your program. Anyway, God bless Rick. That's all I want to say.
One, two, three. Thank you.
Good evening. This is the Guitar 2 class. We build on the foundation of Guitar 1 and develop technique and rhythms and note reading skills, and we move up the fretboard. We work on solo pieces. It's a really great level up from Guitar 1. So I'm really, really pleased that we get to honor tonight to Dr. Madriguera. I studied with Sabina Madriguera many years ago, and he and Enric and Sabina played at my wedding almost 20 years ago, so I have many fond memories, and we're just really honored to get to dedicate this evening to him. We're going to start with a duet piece, a sonatina. It's a duet that these guys will be playing for you. The next two pieces we're playing are solo pieces. We spend a lot of time working on solo music in this class, and so we like to present them here in the concert. We play them in small groups, and we'll be playing in a large group. So the first group is a small group. We have the first five students over here. We have Audrey and Anthony and Brandon and Wyatt and Jarrett. We'll be playing Exercise 126. I really wish it had a name and it wasn't just Exercise 126, but it's a beautiful piece, so I hope you enjoy it. And the next two pieces, the next one is the Rondo as a whole group solo piece, and then followed by Scarborough Fair, which is an ensemble quartet. As they're getting set up, I'd like to introduce the Guitar Ensemble, who studied very, very well with Dr. Madriguera this semester. And Dr. Wilder was very gracious and stepped in and helped kind of polish things up these last 2 weeks, but all of the work they did was with Dr. Madriguera. He picked the pieces and set the tempi, and this is all his doing. So we give honor to him with that. I'm excited to hear them play as well. I know it's going to be really wonderful. They have a first set with John Dowland, and a second part with Bach, and a third part with American music by our friend Eddie Healy. I hope you enjoy.
How you hold the guitar, right? I'm a lefty.
Thank you.
tonight. We'd like to finish tonight with a duet. I'll let Logan and David scoot a couple of chairs up here, and Logan will announce the pieces for you.
All right, good evening. I'm Logan Brazil. Sorry, I have to be closer to the mic, apparently. I'm Logan Brazil. This is David Matthew. And before I introduce the pieces, I just want to tell y'all, this guitar right here is actually from Russell Cleveland that Dr. Madriguera actually loaned to me, and this was actually during our last ensemble with him. So I figured I'd be playing this in his honor. And but for the duo pieces we're going to be playing, we're going to be playing two. The first one is Tema de Jaimito by Peta Negra, which is a flamenco blues piece, which those two combined sound pretty nice. And then the other one is actually from a video game called The Legend of Zelda Ocarina of Time. It is actually Gerudo Valley by Koji Kondo in the form of a guitar duet. So, hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.